Hello and good afternoon students. I welcome you all for our today's EVS 1 lesson. Students, we have started with EVS 1 lesson 1, our environment, and we have finished with the first part of the lesson. Before starting to the next part, let us revise what you have studied in first part. We have studied things in our environment are divided in two groups, and those two groups are living things and non-living things. Further, living things are divided into more groups, and those two groups are plants and animals, and we human beings come in group of animals. Now, without wasting our time, let's start with the next part of the lesson. Okay, now on page 3, you have a question, can you tell? Are the things in this pictures living or non-living? If it is a living thing, is it an animal or an, sorry, is it a plant or an animal? Now, if you will see here, first picture is of a plant. Now, this is a banyan tree. And this banyan tree comes in group of living things, and further in living things it comes in a group of plant. Then next picture you have rabbit. Now this rabbit comes in group of living things, and in living things it comes in group of animal. Then next picture you have frog. It is again a living thing and it comes in group of animal. The next picture you have gas cylinder. This gas cylinder is a non-living thing. Then you have picture of a glass, which is also a non-living thing. Then next you have picture of a pot. Now pot is a non-living thing, but the rose plant is a living thing and it comes in group of plants. The next picture you have a kitchen utensil. It is also coming in group of non-living thing. Then next picture you have picture of a coconut tree. Coconut tree comes in group of living things, and in living things it comes in group of plants. Next, use your brain power. Now use your brain power means you have to think and tell. A railway engine goes to and fro. To and fro means, children, it moves forward and backward. Now, is it a living or a non-living thing? Now, railway engine, it is a non-living thing. It moves because there is a driver who moves it, and that is why it moves. Otherwise, it is a non-living thing. Then next you have down, wood comes from trees, which are living things. A chair is made from wood. So now, is the chair living or non-living? Children, chair is non-living. Trees are living things, but the wood which we get from that, it is coming in group of non-living things. Next, can you tell which birds do you see in your surroundings? Now see, if you look out from your window, so many birds you can see. So let us see which birds we see in our surroundings. I'll show you some pictures. See, this is mynah, pigeon, sparrow, parrot. These are few birds which we see in our surroundings. Then next question you have, can you name some things that are made from stone? Now let us see which things are made from stone. See, here you have the structure of a temple which is made by stone. Then you have here picture of a house. This is also made by stone, by using stone. Then here you have few steps which are made by using stone. This is a flower pot which is also made by using stone. This mortar pestle, it is also made by making use of stone. So these are few things which are made by making use of stone. Now next, after this, we'll study the relationship between all things in the environment. Now see children, here you have picture of water. This water is very important for us to live. Without water, we cannot survive. That is, we cannot live. We use water for so many purposes. But if we don't get to drink water, we cannot live. Water is very important for us. And this water, which is very important for us, we get it from our environment. And at the same time, air, which we get from our environment, is also important for us to live. We need air to breathe. Yes, so air is also important for us to live. And this air which we take in form of oxygen, we get it from our environment. Not only we human beings, but all living things need water and air. Now along with water and air, living things also need food. Now this food which we have, if you are eating eggs we get from hen is coming in group of animals. Then fruits, what we eat, these fruits we get from plants. Vegetables also we get from plants. So whatever food we eat, we get some food from animals and some we get from plants. And plants and animals, they are part of our environment. So living things need food, water and air. And this food, water and air, they get from their environment. Next, birds, they build a nest, and this nest are a shelter for them. We live in a house. Yes, our house is our shelter. Same way, birds, they build this nest and this is a shelter for them. Okay, now to make this nest, they need certain things. Like, to make this nest, they need cotton. This cotton they get from their environment. That is, cotton they get from cotton plant. Plants are in our environment only. They are part of our environment. Then not only cotton, they also need twigs. And these twigs, they are also part of trees. See, twigs means nothing children, but a thin part of a branch of a plant. Okay, so this thin part is called twigs. And this is used to make the nest. So cotton, then twigs and threads, these are used to build the nest. And these things plant